This is Charles Tassel and Heather Adams with National REIA, and we're here to touch base on a couple of things today on inspections. Inspections are critical. Do you just buy your property and let it sit there?
No, you don't want to do that.
We want to make sure we're following up on it.
Regularly.
There's an old proverb that says, check your flocks and watch your sheep. And if you're not following up on them, the wolves are going to eat them, take them apart, and all of that. So we want to make sure we're following up on our inspection ideas here. And one of the things to do is, you know, we do an inspection before we do walkthroughs. When the resident comes here, we do an inspection with them. Then do we wait a year, 2 years? How long should we wait before we do an inspection?
I think ideally you'd like to do it at least twice a year. Some people do it more often just so they can check and make sure things are being taken care of and lease violations aren't being made. Or if you have a neighbor complaining, put it in the lease that this is how many times you come out, or that with a 24-hour notice possibly you can come whenever you want. The more often the better. It is your property and you want to make sure that it's in good condition.
And that 24-hour notice is important because that's state law, at least in several states, and you want to make sure you are complying with what your state law is for notification for inspection, giving that amount of leeway so your resident knows that you're coming. And to do inspection, one early inspection I thought was always an interesting one is checking the underneath the refrigerator to make sure it's clear. Now, underneath the refrigerator, you've got piping under there that collects dust dramatically, and it gets bad very quickly. By cleaning that, you actually extend the life of your refrigerator quite a bit. By doing that every 6 months, it also allows you to get in there to see your unit. And that's an important thing. When you go, the ability to come in to see your house, your apartment, and walk through and look around and say, well, that's interesting. Did I get a new hole in that wall? You know, those are the kinds of things where you show up and it's like, gee, where did these six guys that are just kind of hanging out? Why are they here? Are these guests? What's going on here? And you're looking at both the structural issue that you're inspecting, but you're also keeping your eyes open for the behavioral issues that are going on as well. And sometimes that means the bong that's sitting on the table, the marijuana leaves sitting over there, and there's worse. We've all run across it. We'll talk about some of the worst ones when we talk about the pest control side, because you have to get inside to very personal areas, and it's amazing what people will hide in their apartments or their rentals. So, but making sure that one is, if you're going to do the inspection, it's got to be what? It's got to be in the lease. Making sure that the resident knows ahead of time that you will be coming to do those. And part of what that does, it sets the expectation that you're going to be checking on your property and your investment. And by doing that, it lets them know up front, I can't be doing funny stuff here. Don't try to hide, hey, we're going to do our counterfeiting office here. Don't mess with it. Don't do it here. And that sends a very clear message to make sure that you're taking care of the property. That works not only for the bad guys, but it also works for the good guys to let them know, they are taking care of it and they're looking into my interest as well. And if my neighbor is acting up, I can call my landlord, and they're going to look into it. And having management and letting the residents know that the management is taking care of it, that helps as well with neighbors. If the neighbors are happy, it's a whole lot easier to rest. Now, some neighbors will never be happy. That's plain and simple. We all recognize that. But making sure that to the extent we can, by following up with inspections, we can find code problems, habitability problems. We can find, gee, we've got somebody who's running wires. Came to Christmas time and they decorated their house like mad, so much so that they've got wires running all over the place. And this is becoming a fire hazard. Now we've got some code problems. We can start dealing with them on what they need to address before it becomes a fire problem and I get a call from the fire department saying, by the way, your investment's burned down. So those are some things that we look for. And it's really about opportunity for good resident relations. Customer service.
They know that you'll be there and they can address their issues when you come next time. It goes a long way.
That's right. Now, one of the things we want to talk about on that customer service side is once we put somebody in there, even if we're doing our inspections, at some point that lease expires. When that lease expires, is it in our interest to keep them there? Usually, yes. Now, there are some people, those ones aside, that we go, okay, we're not renewing that lease. We've already made that mind up because of other issues going on. But assuming we want to keep them, this is where you really start to add value to long-term for your property. And that's a long-term resident who's going to stay there. But if I let my 1960 unit look like a 1960 unit all the way up to 1975, and I say that because we can all imagine the different color variations that go from the avocado to the shag carpet, it happens still today, whether it's the granite or, you know, the Formica to, you know, the big push is Formica's coming back. Who knows? We'll see. If we let the unit or our house become staged in one style and it stays in that style and it never upgrades, eventually the resident even is going to go, I can get something new. I'm not tied here. So talking with them and looking at what can we bring in, what can we update, and maybe what, paint? That's an easy one to paint. Sometimes we're looking at appliances. Now appliances, you know, do I want to change appliances if I don't necessarily need to change appliances? That's where maybe buying the general non-stylistic appliances is actually better for us for the long term. But are there other things that we can purchase for them? Maybe it's putting in a fan. You know, a $100 fan with a $100 installation may keep a resident for a whole nother year or two. What's the investment worth on that? And that's the kind of thing we want to start looking at. What are some things that are a good return on investment for me, but are also a good amenity for them, and it's also a good value for the house? Those are kinds of things, that's a win-win-win-win, and you cannot, if you ignore those, again, you might as well not even bother investing in the property in the first place because you're not taking care of it long-term. So when it comes to renewals, make sure that you're following up on looking at the property as you're doing your inspections. Does the carpet need to be replaced? Does it need to be cleaned? And it may be something where, you know what, I've got an older lady who stays here, but the carpet definitely needs to be cleaned. She's got some grubby little grandkids that come in periodically, and it's dirty. It's not torn up, but it is dirty. And I know that her ability to clean it isn't necessarily there. It might be in my best interest to say, you know what, so if you're going to sign up for that, let me get this carpet cleaned for you. And guess what? I've sent a message of what I'm trying to take care of my property. And that message will continue on in the way she watches over it and takes care of that property as well.